Hi, I'm sergesiou and welcome to macStudioA. In this tutorial, we'll be demonstrating how to create a macOS X Mavericks 10.9 USB boot disk. Let's get started. What you'll need: an Intel-based Mac system, at least an 8 or 16 gigabytes USB disk. Make sure to make a backup as all data will be erased. And finally, a downloaded copy of OS X Mavericks 10.9 developer preview, currently only available to registered Apple developers. Very important, make sure that you have a backup of your hard drive whenever you're working with the Mac Disk Utility Program. After the download of OS X Mavericks developer preview from the Mac App Store is complete, don't press continue, but instead quit the install procedure as shown here. Incidentally, pressing continue will install Maverick as an upgrade on your current OS X, preserving all apps and user accounts on your Mac. Therefore, to perform a clean install of Mavericks on your Mac, we need to create an OS X USB boot disk. Unlike the method used in part 1 for creating a Mountain Lion USB boot disk from the Blueprint series on this channel, creating a Mavericks USB boot disk requires a slightly different approach. Assuming you have Mavericks, navigate to its location, usually downloaded to the Applications folder. We need to mount the install esd.dmg file contained in the Mavericks package and locate it in the Shared Support folder to the desktop. Therefore, right-click on the Mavericks icon and scroll to where it says Show Package Contents. Now double-click on the Contents folder and navigate to the Shared Support folder. Then double-click on the Shared Support folder and double-click on the install esd.dmg file to mount it to the desktop. The mounted disk folder contains Packages folder plus additional hidden files. The hidden file we are interested in is named basesystem.dmg. Therefore, we need to unhide this. In order to do so, we need to launch the terminal application and enter the following default command string to unhide the file and the command string to relaunch Finder. If you have entered the command strings correctly, the basesystem.dmg file should be visible. We'll come back to this later. Next, we need to configure the USB disk for Mavericks. Launch the Disk Utility application and then insert the USB disk. And in the Disk Utility window, click on the 16GB flash disk or whatever size you're using. Then click the Erase tab. Then the Erase button here to start the erasing process. The process took about 18 seconds. We'll just time-lapse it at this point. Next, we need to partition the USB disk. Make sure that your USB disk is still highlighted. Now click the Partition tab. This takes a few seconds to load. Once loaded, go to the partition layout and click on the current drop-down list. Then click on one partition. Now click on the Options button. This will bring up the partition options available. As this is an Intel-based Mac, and by default, the GUID partition table button is already selected. So all we need to do is press the OK button and click Apply. Once the pop-up folder appears, and when ready, press the partition button. This will begin to partition the USB disk in order for it to auto-boot. The process took about 18 seconds, and again, we'll time-lapse it at this point. Now that we have the USB disk partitioned correctly, we are ready to copy the unhidden file basesystem.dmg onto it. In order to proceed, make sure that the untitled one partition is highlighted. Drag and drop the basesystem.dmg from the mounted disk folder to the source area of the disk utility window. Click and drag the untitled one partition to the destination area. Now press the restore button to proceed. You will then be presented with a dialog folder asking if you're sure. Press the erase button when ready. You will finally be presented to enter your admin details. Enter your name and password and press OK to begin the first part of the USB Mavericks boot disk creation. The process took about 5.5 minutes and we'll just time-lapse it at this point. Once created, a pop-up folder will appear showing the name of the USB boot disk, which has been renamed to OS X Base System, along with all files and folders associated in it. Now for the second and final part, and in order to complete the creation of the Mavericks USB boot disk, we need to delete the alias file named packages from the USB boot disk. The file is located in the installation folder. So, navigate to the installation folder on the USB disk and locate the packages file and delete it by moving it to the trash. Next, from the mounted disk folder, copy the packages folder by dragging and dropping it to the installation folder of the USB disk. The process took 18.5 minutes. Yeah, you guessed it. We'll time-lapse it again at this point. And that's it. OS X Mavericks 10.9 USB boot disk is ready for use. Enjoy. Oh, by the way, let's not forget to rehide the files in Finder. Basically, bring back the terminal window and type or copy and paste the following command string, adding false at the end of the line to hide the files as before. Then enter the following command string to relaunch Finder. That's it, done like dinner. Thank you for watching. Thumbs up if you like this video, and please don't forget to subscribe to be notified of the latest upcoming tutorials or episodes. Thanks and peace.